According to report findings from the Uganda High Commission in Abu Dhabi, which was issued to Parliament Committee of Defense, 16 Ugandans who were taken to work committed suicide in United Arab Emirates towards the end of last year. Their death was attributed to the excessive torture and suffering they face in these countries while executing their duties. It is this horrible situation that has forced the committee members, including Butambala MP Mwanga Chivumbi and Donozio Kahonda of Ruhinda North Constituency, to put to task the Ministry of Internal Affairs officials, including the Minister General JJ Odong, to explain why more Ugandans have continued to leave the country, with majority being smuggled by illegal companies.
People going in Abu Dhabi. The rest of the question, I'm leaving it, because it deals with the Minister of Gender, where they reside. For you, I want to only settle on the immigration, because we cannot permit Ugandans to be taken outside and be taken into slavery.
I'm aware of this, what he has just described was thoroughly discussed, as I mentioned earlier, 3 weeks ago between the Committee of Foreign Affairs of Parliament, Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Services, and Ministry of Internal Affairs.
After his one-week visit to United Arab Emirates, MP Mwanga Chivumbi further revealed the miserable manner in which Ugandans working in Arab countries are treated.
I met three Ugandans who have nowhere to reside. Actually, the fourth one had run mad.
Whether they go to London first, whether they go to New York first before ending up in Dubai, Omani, or anywhere, and whether they are sold in an open market or whether they are sold in a secret market, cannot be per se the responsibility of the Department of Immigration or the Ministry of Uganda per se. It is the responsibility of us Ugandans and our government, and therefore it is an inter-ministerial issue.
In response, General JJ Odong admitted that the issue of Ugandans trafficked to Arabic countries has gone beyond their control, given the new tactics by the traffickers.
Fortunately, I am not privy to that lesson, to that letter, and therefore I am not in a position to comment. I wish I could have a copy of that letter.
He further revealed that they are working hand in hand with several security agencies, including the Ministry of Gender, to put an end to the long-term complaints of Ugandans smuggled and tortured abroad. Report by Rachel Nakasi for Urban TV.